If you were alive during the early to mid-2000s, or even if you just saw the movie Shrek, you're probably already familiar with the insanely gorgeous ballad Hallelujah as performed by Jeff Buckley, Rufus Wainwright, and originally written by Leonard Cohen. But Hallelujah is actually a really difficult song to sing well. So what is it exactly that makes Hallelujah so captivating? And how can you sing it better? I'll show you.
Let's go.
Hallelujah was written in 1984 by Leonard Cohen and had a really kind of weird trajectory to become the huge mainstream phenomenon song that it is. There's no doubting this is one of the best songs of all time. And a huge reason for the success of the song is not just the lyrics or the chord progression, but also the performances by vocalists like Jeff Buckley and Rufus Wainwright that really brought the song to kind of its fullest self, its fullest realization. But many beginning singers go to sing Hallelujah thinking it's going to be really easy, but then they're surprised to find out how difficult it is. Today, I want to show you what makes Hallelujah so interesting, and then actually break it down into a few exercises you can use to master this song. It's incredibly tempting to sing the song Hallelujah over and over and over again, and think that it's getting better. But actually, you have to break this song down into its core components. Because remember, practice doesn't make perfect, practice makes permanent, especially with bad habits. Instead, you need to learn how to break a song down into its core parts and learn how to master each part of that correctly. That's why today I'm going to introduce you to a fantastic system for breaking a song down. That way you can really, really break it down into bite-sized pieces. I call this the SMART system. The SMART system takes into account the vocal style, the melody, the vocal area or the vocal registers used in the song, the vocal range, and finally the key takeaways. And what is the song really about? What are you really getting out of it? This is actually the exact same system that I used to break down over 150 vocal songs in my resource, 150 Vocal Songs for Singers. So in order to learn how to sing Hallelujah better, let's break it down. Okay, this is a page directly from 150 Vocal Songs for Basses, Baritones, and Tenors, the male version of this resource. Now, if we look at the page, we're going to see a couple things right off the bat. Number one, we'll see that this is recommended to be a tenor song for beginners. So yes, even you can learn how to sing this better. It's written in the key of C. And for the purposes of teaching, I typically opt to listen to the Rufus Wainwright version. That is not a slight to Jeff Buckley at all. I absolutely love Jeff Buckley. But the reason that I chose the Rufus Wainwright version is because it's actually in time. It's done to tempo, which tends to make it easier to learn and memorize. Now, let's actually break this song down into the SMART system. The first step is looking at the vocal style of this song.
I've heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you?
It's like he's not even trying. It's just like so easy. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift. But a couple of things to note really quickly. We have Rufus Wainwright's beautiful light tenor voice, and you'll also notice that there is tons and tons of vibrato on every single sustain in this entire song. So if vibrato is something that you're not able to do right now, that might be something that you want to look at or even use this song as an opportunity to start teaching yourself. Overall, the vocal style is like really light and pretty, a little breathy, exceptionally gorgeous. That I've heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. Next, let's actually look at the vocal melody of the song, because obviously the style gives us some information, but there's so much more to this song in terms of melody than just the style.
It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing Hallelujah.
So the melody for Hallelujah is really simple, but incredibly beautiful. And what I love about it is it walks up and it walks up and it walks up. So it just starts there on the G3 and then moves up to the C4 and then up and then up. And then that's the only time when it starts to come back down. Now, unlike a lot of other songs where the verses are kind of like tame or lower energy and then the chorus is where the big payoff is, with this song, it's like a really, really beautiful, slow and low chorus. It's like a prayer.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
And it just taps on those bottom notes, just really, really easy. Now, if we didn't know what we were looking for in the vocal melody, you might think that this song is really easy. But actually, if we look at the melody on the actual sheet itself, we'll see that we have this stepwise movement up the C major scale from the G3 all the way up to the E4, which the E4 is a really, really difficult note for a lot of guys to sing because it's right in between the bottom and the top parts of their voice.
It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah.
Yeah, if that E4 is a little bit difficult for you, you know, one of the great things that you can do in a song like this is that you can just gently glide up into that E4 rather than pushing up to it. And that's what a lot of singers do when they go to sing the song. They're like, oh, this is easy. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king compose it. And before they know it, they're in trouble. Instead, with this one, you want to go really gradual, really easy. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah. And that brings us beautifully into the next step in our smart system, which is the vocal area. What vocal registers does the song explore? Well, definitely we have a lot of chest voice, or the bottom part of the singing voice.
Well, I've heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord.
But as I just mentioned, during the pre-chorus, we actually have that stepwise motion going all the way up into the first passage. So if you're a little bit shaky in your first passage, you might want to try that on an exercise. Like a mum-mum-mum-mum-mum-mum-mum. 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 Until you get it a little bit more set in your voice, and then you can go back to the song. But that's not what most singers do with this song. Instead, they'll just sing it over and over and over again, and they'll strain on that E4, hallelujah, every single time, and that isn't going to get them any better. As a matter of fact, it's going to train them to sing with bad habits. Next, it's time to look at the vocal range of hallelujah. And notice that I put the vocal range after the vocal area. That's because there are many songs that you can sing that have a fantastic vocal range, but they're quite easy to sing because maybe you're just whispering a couple of high notes up there. As a matter of fact, the vocal area, or understanding which parts of your voice you need to sing in, can be just as important. But when we look at this song, every single version that you look at will have a slightly different range. In the Wainwright version, we have the distance of an octave and a fourth, which is actually a really, really nice distance, just under the distance of an octave and a fifth, which is the same for like the Star Spangled Banner, for instance. So we can go from the C3 down here all the way up to the F4, that we have just on a little touch of a note towards the end of the song. And depending on which version you look at, you might have this little beautiful major six jump from the hallelujah. In that case, that F4 would be the highest note in the song. Now, let's look at some of the key takeaways, what the song is really about for hallelujah. There are so many fantastic takeaways for a song like hallelujah. First of all, it's exceptionally beautiful. It's done by amazingly beautiful singers, and it can be reinterpreted in so many different ways. But at the same time, it gives a lot of beginning singers the ability to gradually move into that first passage rather than just straining up on into it. One of the best tricks that I use to help my students sing that pre-chorus better is to start by narrowing their vowels. And if we listen to the Rufus Wainwright version, we can hear he's doing the same thing.
It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift.
So he's not going the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall. He's singing the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift. And he does the exact same thing as he approaches those higher notes. So for instance, when you're going up to those higher notes, you can start to change that fall into a little bit more of a full, the minor fall and the major lift. And that will help you connect to those notes so much better. Just remember that the entire goal of all vocal training is to give you the freedom to be able to make whatever sound you want. But I have to warn you, hallelujah can be a really difficult song to sing, especially if you've done it a million times and have done it wrong over and over. So now that you're working with me, you need to break every song that you look at down into its core components by using the smart system. To see the complete teardown of Hallelujah, as well as breakdowns of 300 plus other songs, check out my resource, 150 Vocal Songs for Singers, right here.